Hi, I'm Jay Preskitt, Well Operations Engineer in the Gulf of Mexico region of the Bureau of Safety and Environmental Enforcement, also known as BSEE. BSEE's blowout preventer systems and well control rule, often called the well control rule, is one of four rules enacted over the last several years to address safety in drilling operations. In accordance with executive and secretarial orders, BSEE proposed revisions to the well control rule in May 2018. I served on the team that completed the regulatory review, considered the more than 118,000 public comments received, and has now finalized the revisions. In this video, we will discuss some key technical aspects of the rule, such as what is a blowout preventer and how do BSEE's revisions affect the requirements for blowout preventers. A blowout preventer, or as you're likely to hear, a BOP, is a critical piece of safety equipment and crucial to the offshore oil and gas industry's ability to keep the Gulf of Mexico safe. A BOP is made up of multiple rams, annulars, and sets of fail-safe valves. The BOP's critical function is to control the flow of wellbore fluids during drilling, completion, or well testing operations. BOPs can vary in size, with some reaching as tall as 50 to 60 feet. BOPs are either located on a drilling rig or subsea on the ocean floor. The well control rule revisions do not eliminate the requirement for offshore operators to use BOPs. Instead, the revisions clarify the requirements for BOPs to be used for the purpose for which they were designed. For example, one revision helps to ensure maximum functionality of the BOP by requiring that the system employ an arrangement of rams with specific capabilities. Rams are pairs of opposing steel blocks that extend toward the center of the wellbore to restrict flow. There are four common types of rams: fixed, variable, shear, and blind shear. Each type has different capabilities. The revision will allow the most effective use of each ram type. Two separate revisions reduce the risk of BOP failures. One revision accomplishes this by updating the requirements for the remotely operated vehicle interface with the BOP, which helps ensure equipment standardization and design consistency. The other does it by updating the requirements for dedicated accumulator capacity. The revision provides flexibility for operators to utilize accumulators with sufficient capacity to perform the BOP's emergency functions without exceeding the operational or mechanical design limits of the wellhead and BOP systems. BSEE's revisions also improve the expected lifespan of a critical BOP component by specifying a testing methodology that provides a readiness check without putting unnecessary wear and tear on the component. All of BSEE's revisions to the requirements for BOPs are in alignment with the administration's goals of making regulations safer and smarter, protecting workers and the environment, and securing America's energy future. Thank you for your time and your interest in America's energy future.